Hello, this is Solar PVTV once again from Australia, from All Energy event. And now we are together with Adrian, who is a Global Sales Director for Fronius, one of the guys who were supporting yesterday's party of Solar Juice and one of the most faithful partners of Solar Juice. Hello, Adrian.
Hello, Thomas. Nice to meet you.
How are you?
Very well, very well.
How was the party yesterday?
It was amazing, actually. I no longer get the chance to spend time with Solar Juice so much living in Austria now, but it was nice to see old friends, and they put on a great show. The highlight was Costa's rap song, I think.
Okay. So you were before you were based in Australia.
Yes.
And you were in charge of the Australian activities, but now you moved to the headquarters. Yes.
Yes. Yes. So earlier this year in February, I was given the opportunity to move over to Austria. It's a company I've been with, Fronius, for 7 years now, so I know the people very much, but nice to learn a new culture, a new language, and get to be part of the strategic core part of the company, which has been great.
I remember I told you that quite a lot of years ago, yes, I was acquiring Fronius to Solar Power Europe, yeah, before it was Epia.
Yes, yes, and you met Mr. Gunther Fronius. Yes,
yes, yes, exactly. So, yesterday you were supporting the event of Solar Juice. You are one of the, let's say, top suppliers of Solar Juice. And you are, I spoke with Rami and he told me that you are a very well set up company in Australia. Yes?
Yes.
So, what about your activities in Australia?
Yeah, so we've been in Australia for many years now. Actually, we're celebrating our 25th birthday in the solar industry. And we established a service partner network a long time ago. So in order to be able to support installers, and a big part of that is trying to make them more successful, we need a very strong support infrastructure. So we have service, we have marketing, we have sales, we have warehousing. And of course, then we need great partners. We got involved with Solar Juice a couple of years ago, and they do an amazing job of covering our installer base and keeping our FSPs happy. We love working with them, and it's been a great partnership in the last few years. And we've been able to establish quite a nice market position, actually. So keeping the customer satisfaction high, getting to the next level of service and support is very important. So we have a team of 24 in Melbourne, based in Melbourne. Yeah, and that's our team that covers the Australian market and New Zealand, actually.
So this year, what were the numbers, let's say, in terms of because the market, I think it's going to be like 1.5 gigawatt, yes, in total?
Yes, yes. I'm not sure exactly where it ends up at the end of this year, but we were successful enough to sell well over 300 megawatts already this year. So I believe that puts us at number one in most segments.
So like 30% of the market share?
Yeah, roughly, yeah. And so it's quite overwhelming. When I started, we didn't have that sort of position here. But to see the feedback that we're getting from people now, it's quite inspiring. And I think as partnerships develop and the industry is maturing, it takes much more of a collaborative effort. So to have such a strong base in this country, where it's very innovative, storage is coming on, self-consumption, there's a lot of organic growth, we're very proud to have the type of support that we have here.
So in terms of Fronius on a global level, so which were the latest achievements, let's say, of the company?
Well, the latest, I think Australia has been quite a big achievement for us. So strategically, Australia has become quite an important market.
Maybe that's why you were upgraded, yeah?
I'm not sure. You have to ask my boss about that over in Austria. But, you know, we're very fond of this market because it's right in the target segment of what we do. So we are focusing mainly on residential, commercial, and large-scale PV. The utility segment is not really a core focus for us, and these segments are very important for Australia. But in addition to that, a lot of partnerships. So in the last few years, we've brought out a lot of new products, but in the last year or so, while we're working on our next generation products, you've seen a lot of partnerships with battery manufacturers. This year we have a few different manufacturers featured at our website, featured at our booth as well. And so I think some of those collaborative partnerships have been great achievements. And obviously being 25 years in the solar industry, I think that's something to celebrate too.
And how do you see, you know, the change of the world's paradigm? Yeah? We discussed yesterday also at the party. And how do you observe from, you know, your experience, 7 years experience here in the country, how do you observe, you know, the change of the paradigm in the Australian society?
Yeah, I mean, it's amazing how much it's changed. And at the beginning, it being sort of a gold rush period, to then you know, established players coming through and consolidation happening, to now I think, which is the next phase, where we start to really mature and think about delivering a combined value to the customer. So we realize that this challenge that we have ahead of us, which is really not just about solar, it's about the energy supply for large populations, we start to think about energy sector integration, about changing everything over to renewables. And that's such a big, exciting world. And when you think about that, you contemplate it, you come to the realization that you can't do it as one player. And so even sometimes when you're thinking about your competition, it's not so much a, oh, I want to win against you. It's more, let's raise the bar and let's innovate and collaborate. So I really am excited for the next phase because I think the amount of power we can get collectively is much better than what we can do alone.
And do you also observe, you know, that we are arriving to the point when we're going to start the real exponential growth?
I absolutely do. I do. I think when you think about the amount of energy that's consumed, not even in the form of traditional electricity, if you think about the onset of e-mobility and EVs, and also what I also just mentioned, energy sector integration, turning every source of energy, gas, into electricity, electrifying everything first, you start to see terawatts of energy and or terawatts of opportunity. And it's exciting from a commercial point of view, but beneath that, it's exciting to see how we're going to be able to take on this massive challenge, which is probably one of the most important things for the planet to address. I think now you're seeing different industries getting involved, everybody's sort of racing to figure out how do we work with the smart home, energy intelligence, what we do in commercial. It's quite an exciting time for us.
And Fronius is prepared to be a part of this revolution.
Yes, you might have heard us say 24 hours of sun a lot of the time. It's an initiative, it's our vision. It's not, and we say it's our vision, but it's actually what we hope is everyone's vision. And we're trying to speak to those that also think the same way because we need them. But we've been doing that for the last few years. So even though now we're starting to see this progression and hopefully an acceleration of exponential growth, we've been trying to prepare ourselves for a long time.
And since 25 years.
Since 25 years. And actually, it goes back even further. I mean, we've been around 70 years. So we've had the experience of seeing how industries develop and mature. And we understand that you really, if you want to be a long-term player, you have to really think long-term at the very beginning. The things we're doing now, we're just very happy that the investments we made before seem to be working very well.
And last question. You remember yesterday we spoke about this B2B, B2C, and H2H, human to human. And how important is H2H in Australia? And how do you feel about this H2H understanding by SolarJuice guys?
Yeah, I mean, they embody H2H very well, and I think you said it perfectly last night. And if I look at the stand that we had and all the people that are coming to the stand, there's always new people, but there are some people there that we've known for 6-7 years. And, you know, you come up and people are coming up to you and hugging you, and it's quite overwhelming, and that's really the extrinsic part of the product. We all are here to talk about the latest technology, the differences that we have, to raise the bar and deliver customer value. But beyond that, it's about relationships. I mean, that's the last thing I believe to be commoditized. In a world where technology is getting faster and faster, and we're losing the advantages on our product even faster, what's remaining is that relationship.
H2H.
H2H. I really like that. I hope you don't mind, but I'm going to use that.
That's
trademark.
You can steal it.
Okay.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you. That was PVTV together with Adrian, who is the Austrian guy now. Coming, you know, originally from Australia, a global sales director for Fronius. And one of the partners, faithful partners of SolarJuice. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.